Hello, welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. If you live on the West Coast and you happen to buy any property right near the ocean, there is always a clause that says, I know that this land is in tsunami country, and you sign your name up, initial it. Well, you do it and you think, oh, it'll never happen. Well, we now know what happened in Phuket in Thailand, and my guest today, Tom Miller, has written a novel called The Wave, and it's published by Asher of Santa Fe, New Mexico. Welcome, Tom.
Thank you for having me on the show.
Well, I read the book and I kept saying, it couldn't happen here, but it could.
Absolutely. I expect with someday somebody will be looking up and they will potentially see a wave that's 1,000 feet high crashing onto the West Coast.
At which point they have dropped dead. But the book is about Chuck Palmer.
Correct.
He is has been in the Vietnam War. He has been a sailor, and he has just married Lauren, his dream girl, and they have a little baby. And he gets a call from his friend Scott, who had been in the war with him, and they had both been Navy SEALs. Come to Hawaii because I need you to help me with some underground work that only you will be able to do in a submarine submersible.
Right. He needed him to help him do some diving on this crevasse that he had found that the biology and geology department at the University of Hawaii was concerned about, that it may portend a much larger tsunami than what the islands had recently incurred.
And Scott, who is a professor at the university, even if he is sort of a freewheeling spirit as well, picks up Chuck at the airport, and from there on in, whatever they do, it explodes, because the people who are in the islands do not want what they are discovering known, because it might hurt tourism.
The islands are, they live on tourism, and they protect their tourism. It's amazing that they go to any extent they can to protect their tourism.
Yeah. The other is, of course, they get in a car, there's an accident. They get in a plane, they're lucky it lands. Where do they finally go to start with their, and the boat explodes. Whatever they do, where are they when they first go down into the submersible?
The submersible is launched just off the southeast coast of the Big Island of Hawaii. They go down 6,000 feet.
That's pretty far, isn't it?
That is pretty far. It's the submersible is called the Pisces 5. It is an actual submersible that's operated by the University of Hawaii.
Yeah.
Its dive limit, I think, is 6,250 feet.
Yeah.
So they're still within the limits of the submersible, and they've gone down to investigate the cause of a tsunami. It was only a 20-foot tsunami, which is still quite substantial. But they couldn't figure out what caused it. They think it may have been an undersea landslide that caused the tsunami, and they've gone down the submersible to investigate this landslide and to see if that's actually what caused the tsunami.
I had never heard about this landslide. You know, I read where you say in the book a 6.5 is a note, 7.5 is what, the bulletin?
No. 6.5, earthquakes over 6.5, undersea earthquakes over 6.5, the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center issues a tsunami bulletin. Earthquakes over 7.5, they issue a warning.
And now that warning says what?
The warning says it's just that, there may be a tsunami. It's best to look at and read their warnings, and as I mentioned when we were talking earlier, my website has a link directly to the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center, and we post all of the bulletins and the warnings that they issue. In fact, there was a bulletin issued yesterday for a 6.6 earthquake just off of Japan.
Now, where would a tsunami from Japan hit? Because reading again, where the earthquake is not always where the tsunami goes.
It really depends on the size of the earthquake and the subsequent tsunami. The tsunami can cover the entire Pacific Ocean if the earthquake is in the ocean. The Indian Ocean tsunami went all the way from Phuket all the way to Africa, and actually it bounced back.
Really?
Yes.
Is that unique to have it bounce back?
Not for these very large tsunamis. Yeah. Now, when I say it bounced back, it was detectable as a wave. It wasn't the kind of tsunami that could do any damage at that point.
Yeah, because the one in Phuket, they also mentioned it could hit the West Coast.
Well, I'm not sure how it would get to the West Coast.
I don't know either,
because
but
there's
that
an awful
was
lot
something
of land.
I read in the paper at that time. When one saw the tsunami in Phuket, one did see where it suddenly was, which you say in this book too, there was no water there. It had gone so far out by the tide that it then you saw it come back in. I think all of us had never quite seen what they had photographed in Phuket.
That was some pretty amazing photography. And to watch these huge waves come in and to realize, you know, a tsunami is a much different type of wave than the typical wind waves that we might see, surfers in Hawaii surfing on.
Yep, there's no break.